years. 2 fucking years of doing this.
Yep, that's right, guys. This month marks 2 years that we've been doing the Behind the Fiends podcast. Had some ups and downs. We've had some David Lee Roth quits.
You can fucking say that again. I quit.
But you always come right back.
I do, John.
But anyway, just want to say thank you guys for all the love, all the support, all the subscribes, everything that you've done. It's made it worthwhile, and it's really grown, and it's not because of us. It's because of you.
Except for you, Kevin. Fuck you.
Comics King.
Bitch.
But anyway, what we have compiled here is some of mine and Luke's most...
intimate moments.
Intimate moments, our funniest clips from some of the old audio podcasts that we Fano snapped not that long ago, but I hope... as a collector and hoarder, I held on to a lot of these old clips, and for you guys and your viewing enjoyment, we're going to present to you 1 hour. Almost 1 hour.
Is it an hour?
Almost an hour of just John and Luke's insanity, sexiness.
Get in the bath.
Yeah, so be warned. Put children to bed, because this ain't for the little ears.
Or... put me in your head.
But we present to you 2 years of some of our best clips. Enjoy, guys.
I don't give a shit if you like it or not.
Give them that ooh-ooh. They ain't heard it in a while.
About now is when George Carlin shows up in his phone booth.
Not bad.
Greetings, my excellent friend.
Like,
let's get the fuck out of here.
Like, this ain't where it is, okay?
We gotta go get Socrates. Mm-hmm. Or Socrates.
Gentlemen, I'm here to help you with your history report.
I just want you to suck my dick in this phone booth.
Because it's a roll of the road.
What?
Hey, where are we going, George? I need you to get down. Down there. Get on your knees. Where's Bill? He's down there. He's
look, a... Rufus just needs you to suck his dick.
there's really nothing more to it. I just really need my dick sucked.
You get down there, I'll dial the number.
It's been like a couple of years, man. And it still works. I'd like to use it a little
just
bit.
Just think of it this way. When you're done, we'll be in ancient Egypt.
Dude, are you sure we should be doing this?
We're going to get to see the Pharaoh. Mm-mm. You need that history grade.
Bill... strange things are afoot at the Circle K.
What was that commercial Jack Palance used to do? Skin Bracer?
I need some fancy cologne to tell me I'm a man. I use Skin Bracer. It smells great. But it also cools and tones my skin.
We don't want to smell like a man.
Oh, my God.
I use Skin Bracer.
Jesus Christ.
Confidence is very sexy, don't you think?
Original and Cooling Blue. By men.
Is that Narnia?
Narnia? What's that?
Well, dear girl, you're in it. Everything from the lamppost all the way to Castle Caer Paravel on the Eastern Ocean. Every stick and stone you see, every icicle, is Narnia.
I'm just in Narnia right now. What the fuck was the point of that guy?
Who, Dumbus?
Dumbus Dick. Was he like what's-his-face from Avengers or Thor? What's that blind black dude's name that fucking controlled the bridge?
He wasn't blind.
Oh.
He just had weird looking eyes.
Oh.
Himdale.
Himdale. It's like Hyman or something. I am the protector of Asgard. In Hyman.
In the Rainbow Road.
In the Rainbow Road. Oh my god. Oh god. Yeah, but like him. Is that what Dumbledick's job for Narnia was?
Dumbus. Wrong universe.
I'm sorry. Yeah. Dumbus. Dumbus Dick.
I guess he was like, come through the wardrobe.
Welcome to Narnia.
Now touch my butt.
You notice I'm wearing nothing but a scarf?
I have a fawn's anus.
It's awfully cold.
But it's warm in here.
Follow me.
I'm sorry. Please allow me to introduce myself. My name is Tumnus.
Pleased to meet you, Mr. Tumnus.
Sorry. Is that how it went?
Yeah.
Oh my
Get
god.
Magic together.
Atreyu!
What is it? Don't Bastion? We gotta go see the rock biters.
Desert.
The never-ending story.
Oh my god. Did you have that, like, that albino black guy with the fucking penis head?
So know that you have come to beseech the Empress for help. But I have terrible news.
And like the fucking sorcerer eyebrows and shit. That was fantastic.
We're glad to have you here, Bastion.
Oh shit, easy. You scared me.
We need you to save the never-ending story.
What the fuck does that mean?
Am I high?
My horse just died.
Atreyu!
That wasn't the name of his horse. I think it was like Thunderstrike or something.
The never-ending story. Mr. Anderson.
As you can see, we've had our eye on you for some time now, Mr. Anderson.
Name's Neo, bitch.
Mm. I'm really glad you didn't write the movie.
It would have been better.
In some ways, yes. In most ways, no. But I would have appreciated it nonetheless.
I would have shortened up that goddamn rave scene.
Oh my god. I would have cut all of that shit out. Longer freeway scene, that was fucking awesome.
Them in there eating gruel in that rave, that was a little depressing.
Yeah.
And then all that loud techno music, what did it do? And then ended up bringing all those octopus robots down there on them.
It's like, can you just add less water next time? So, I mean, does it have to be this fucking soupy? Ease up on the water.
It's every goddamn day, it's cream wheat.
It's okay, just ease up on the water. It's like I'll be eating something different.
It's cream wheat ice cream.
Whatever.
Cream wheat bowl. You've even tried to shape it into a steak, but because it's so watery, it don't hold.
It's just pure nutrition, so you can rave your ass off.
I've got diarrhea.
Doesn't matter.
Hard to find toilet paper down here in this cave.
Just dance it out. It's just right in place. Just dance on top of it.
Stomping like a mud pit at Woodstock.
What are we fucking talking about?
Stomping in your own shit.
Are we rewriting the Matrix? I took both pills.
It's Woodstock, baby.
Who are you, replacement Morpheus?
Remember, all I'm offering is the truth, nothing more.
Along these dark tunnels, which take you further underground, strange shapes have been seen floating towards unsuspecting visitors. With paranormal sightings in abundance, we have to uncover the mystery of the Hellfire Caves.
Fuck that. Who cares? He lost me at his stupid name. That was the coolest thing about him. And he made pussy caves.
Dashwood's Pussy Cave. 50 cent.
See? We made it better. You're fucking welcome. Moon Isn't Real is one of my favorites. It is such an anomaly because just the size of it and the rotation of it, it spins weird. No one knows where the fuck it came from. Some people say it's hollow. Some people say there are towers on it. It's just crazy as shit.
There have been people that have zoomed in a telescopes on it and seen craft flying into it.
I could watch it all damn day long.
Have you seen that?
I have. Absolutely. Yeah, there's one of the moon glitching. There's all kinds of shit involving the moon. Guys, look up moon shit.
Is it made out of cheese?
They're always cold up there.
Yep.
And Michelle, and look, you're used to it, okay, El Presidente? That's why I feel good about you being in charge. You can handle those cold conditions.
You're our Alpine and our G.I. Joe team.
Basically. Who are you?
Roadblock, baby.
Yes, sir. All right. That's fair. Oh, my God.
Who are you, Duke?
Fuck you, man. No.
G.I. Joe.
But my mom's over there. Every time I talk to her, you think she crawled out of, like, I don't know. She's somewhere on Hoth, right?
Crawling out of that Tauntaun belly.
Hang on, kid.
Yeah, basically. There's times like that she wish she had a Tauntaun to sleep in. Oh, man.
They smell bad. On the outside.
That's exactly what has just been observed among a swarm of unique pseudo-organisms called xenobots, first developed in 2020 at the University of Vermont. Xenobots are effectively living robots, biological machines designed from the ground up using skin and cardiac stem cells derived from the African frog Xenopus laevis, hence xenobots.
Are you ready, John? Oh. Are you ready to mount up, son? You're on my team, man. I'm gonna need that fucking hero experience.
I want a big old enema full of frog robots.
I will sit in stirrups and have you run up on me with it.
You want me to flash run it?
Can. Make sure. Let me just run bite on something, okay? Okay.
Gotta make sure you open up because I only get one shot. It's like that.
Hey.
It's like that.
Hey, listen, I'm relaxed. Would you shut up?
I'm just saying, it's like the Death Star run, you know. I only got that small little port there, that little exhaust port. I got
what
to
the
hit.
Fuck is a Death Star run?
You're all clear, kid. Now let's blow this thing and go home. I can hold it.
And Luke had to shoot that thing down the hole, remember?
I got it as I was saying it. And it was very funny.
Use the force.
Because you got a sweet little target. And if I'm going to get these Inobots and all that they have to offer, you cannot afford to miss.
Porkins is on the case, baby.
Oh. Oh, man.
Hey, Luke! Turns out my midichlorian counts were off the charts!
I don't like horror comics.
You like this one, Mr. Phoenix. Well, it could save your life.
Goonies, son. Goonies was like a hit, right? As soon as it came out, it's like one of those blockbusters.
And that's what they originally tried to do with Lost Boys, was trying to make it like a Goonies with vampires, but what's his name? Joel Schumacher was like, no, we're not fucking doing that.
Why not?
Because I'm glad they didn't. I didn't want it to be all this children, kid-friendly
bullshit.
Let me bullshit.
Fucking tell you something, ponytail. Get the fuck down there like a goddamn dog.
What the fuck?
Don't you fucking look at me.
No eye contact will you suck my dick.
They're not sucking my dick. I just want to sit there, think about shit
while I suck like my own dick.
Build a fucking dog they are. Look at you. You're filthy. I'm just trying to instill some discipline in old Schumacher.
He's dead.
Is he?
Yeah, man. Schumacher kicked the bucket a while back.
Oh, shit. Sorry. R.I.P. Rest easy.
Choo-choo.
One love. Take it, please.
First, you gotta do the truffle shuffle. Come on. Do it. Come on. Do it.
This program contains true stories of rescues. All of the 911 calls you will hear are real. Whenever possible, the actual people involved have helped us reconstruct the events as they happened.
Those work. You ever try one of those?
No, man, because I had a friend that used one one time and got a little carried away with the pump. And
oh, what happened? It killed his penis?
He called my buddy to go over to his house. I don't want to say their names because it's really embarrassing for him, so I'm not going to give their names. But
can we give them aliases? We'll just say it's
Fry Kids.
Fry Kid 1 decided he was going to get it on with his lovely lady friend.
Okay.
So she put the penis pump on there, and I guess she didn't read the instructions, so she sucked that thing up in there till there was no room at all. I mean, she filled the entire cylinder with his wiener. When they went to turn that fucking valve, to release, the vacuum seal was sealed, son. They weren't coming out.
No.
So he freaked out and started calling people in our little group of friends. They have to go to his house and have to literally sit there and look at him in pain with his dick inside.
Because he didn't know what to do.
Would have panicked too, bro. Hey, man, y'all got to come help me do my dick.
You just got to go grab some butter. So everything's going to be okay.
So according to Fry Kid 2, they managed to whittle a little hole into the plastic to let all the fucking air out.
That's good.
He had to go to ER.
Yeah, I bet.
That shit was
penis function?
No, but that shit swole up and looked like fucking Grimace.
I bet. Oh, Jesus Christ. Just unusable.
It gave a whole new meaning to the word blue balls.
Yeah, I bet. Did he have everything up in there? Or was it just his dick?
Just his dick.
That's good. Thank God.
I don't know what you would call that, but I'm purple people eater, so I don't know what it is.
That's rough.
Woo! So ever since that story, I'm not letting nobody put no penis pump on me unless you're a trained professional.
This has been Uncle John's wartime stories.
Join us again next week.
When it comes to saving lives, it's not enough to watch how first aid is done by others. In order to perform the techniques effectively, you need training. There are courses available through the American Red Cross and the American Heart Association that can teach you to be prepared if a loved one or a stranger needs your help.
What's the worst Christmas special you've ever watched?
Oh, man. I don't know. I've seen a lot of bad ones.
Outside of that shit, I would have to say Santa Claus is coming to town. I didn't like that, where he was taking on his brother who... No, it was... he was made out of fire.
Yeah.
Squirt.
Oh, that one. Frosty. That was like Frosty. Not Frosty the Snowman. I like Frosty.
It was like the story of Santa Claus, and this guy was trying to make everything like a perpetual summer all the time. Scorch or some shit.
Squirt. Mr. Slick or something. I don't know what it was. It was disgusting. He just slid around out of his big old pussy lips. It was just getting everything all gooey.
It looked like one of the scrubbing bubbles.
Yep.
Scrubbing bubbles. Oh, that's our scrubbing action foams your bathroom clean.
Yeah, dries quick, though. You gotta go over it again.
It leaves soap scum.
Oh, shit. Oh, my God. Oh. All right. We gotta stop.
Brought to you by
SC Johnson, a family company.
Oh, shit. There it is. A glory hole right next to the settling cracks and the door dings.
You should try it out. You should not come out your door. Just get everyone used to seeing your door closed, right? For a week or two. Don't do anything. You can randomly put a glory hole on the front of it. on the third week or so. And then use it and just get some random reaction.
Not just the glory hole, and we'll put a little thing of hand sanitizer right next to it. Say, hey, I got COVID, so you might want to wash up.
That's true. That's very nice of you to warn people about them entering a quarantine zone.
Would you look at that? Frank? D, what you two have discovered today is what is most commonly referred to as a glory hole.
Thank you.
I mean, but when you look at movies like Friday the 13th, look at how stupid they got over time.
Yeah.
Because they're like, oh, well, let's put him in space. Well, let's put him up somebody's ass. Hey, have you ever seen that movie, Inner Space, where that guy got injected into that other guy? Well, we'll do that with Jason.
It was like the Magic School Bus, but with Jason on it.
Yeah. Surfing on the sound wave, swinging through the stars. Take the left at your intestine. Take your second
right past Mars on the Magic School Bus. Navigator nostril. Yeah.
And it was just stupid.
Thanos' ass.
Just fucking stupidity. And they did
it. I expect a commercial out of that.
Violence never solved anything.
Then how do we decide who gets the ball?
Agnew, show him. Yeah! There. How do you like your stupid ball now? Now you know something.
I'm living forever, son.
I'm
like
waiting
I
for...
Like I said, naked and screaming, you gotta catch me.
Well, I've seen these robots, man. So I want to get put in one of them.
Yeah, I'm down. Sign me up. Just like Walt Disney and his goddamn frozen head or whatever it is. Put me...
I don't want to be like Futurama. I don't want to be in a little aquarium where it's just my head.
What if they threw a dick in there? Would you be all right?
No, I don't want it floating around in my face.
You just like suck on it and stuff when you're bored.
Then we discover something quite surprising.
It's getting bigger.
Why is it getting bigger?
It's showing off.
Ballpark Franks. They plump when you cook them.
Okay, listen to this.
Oh, man, life is just full of creepy shit that occurs, you know? I wish I could string it all together, but even in here, you know, when I'm processing comics the night before New Comic Day, I've had nights where I've had, like, random crackheads pressed up against the glass when I look up.
Don't do that, Jesus Christ! You're gonna get me killed! Out of here!
Oh, Billy.
Their body print's just there for a couple of days, trying to scare me and shit. One night I went to go throw away some garbage, and I threw it all over this fucking homeless guy hiding in a dumpster taking a shit. He jumped out screaming at me.
Hey!
Yeah, it's like Oscar the Grouch, man. Scared to
scream.
Shit. Basically. Wasn't cute, though. Wasn't cute at all.
Oh, I love trash.
It's like Triple H, right? He got all big with the blasts. And then you're sitting here telling me before we got started that this guy couldn't even wipe his own ass. He had to get the daughter of the company to come in and clean him up every time he made number two.
How did we get this?
Listen, I'm marking off the list. Let's see, we got the news, got Van Halen. All right.
How did we go from a shitty podcaster to Triple H not being able to wipe his ass?
Because it's shit related. He had to get old Steph in there to help play in the mud and get him all cleaned up.
Time to play the game!
I make it big. I know how to play the game. I buy real estate, hotels, fancy cars, even railroads. And I take chances to make it big. Uh-oh, you've got to play the game. I'm Monopoly Dave.
The Monopoly guy's name is Rich Uncle Pennybags.
Really?
Yep.
Awesome. Yeah. That's a good dick name. You know, I'm going to start using that.
Get you a test audience. Try that on Randy's. How that works out.
I am. That was going to be my next thing I was going to say.
So, hey, girl, you want to see Rich Uncle Pennybags?
You gotta cut that out. I'm sorry. No, it's just all that shit. Next subject.
Says he's depicted as a portly old man with a mustache. He wears a morning suit with a bow tie top hat and has large pants.
Large what?
Pants.
Oh, okay.
Cause he's packing. A penny
like
bag.
What? Like backpacking?
He's
a penny bag.
Yeah.
He's got to give the kids, right?
Ugh.
I was like, don't worry. That bulge is just a bag of pennies.
He just likes to give them to the neighborhood kids.
He shakes it at the bottom of his pants leg like he's...
Oh, my God. Don't go too far. That's good enough.
There's 25 cents. Go get you some bubble gum.
You got to get it. Don't let it get away. Go on the street.
He just does a jumping jack and panties just fall down out of his pants legs.
Oh, my God.
We love you, Ranch Uncle Petty Bags. I love you, too, kids. Jiggle, 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 jiggle. That's not sanitary, you asshole. Bloody fucking meat.
I'm not trying to die of dysentery, all right? You have died at the WAP concert.
Yeah. Shows up on Oregon Trail. Little Timmy died of dysentery at the Wasp concert. Gotta bury him on the side of the road.
Probably can't eat him, huh? Muffin cook him real good.
Gotta get all the germs at it. It's not good unless you sear it real good.
Listen, we're trying to grow. We gotta cut all that out. We're talking about necrophilia. Eating little Billy and shit.
Taken. But why?
You had Street Fighter with fucking that infamous Street Fighter.
Yeah, with fucking Jean-Claude Van Damme.
And it also ended up being, what's his face, is Raul Julia, I think his name is.
Mm-hmm.
His last movie.
I love Raul Julia, but he was kind of shit as M. Bison. God rest your soul, but
Damn. It's gonna be anybody else.
Dude, when you look at that video game, M. Bison's this big jack fucking like third right goddamn looking Nazi fucker, and then you get in that movie and he's just an old man in that same costume and it's like, oh shit.
It's like oversized suit.
Yeah.
Not good. Not good.
But I get it. The dude bros with acting skills was very limited in the 90s, so I got it, you know.
Yeah, you're telling me a big dude bro couldn't just stand there and be a floating asshole?
Yeah, I guess so.
You know?
And to hate whoever wore the helmets. Nevertheless, they remained rebellious and unbroken. And they grew until they were men. But not ordinary men. Barbarians.
That's enough. You're going to jail.
Well, guess who's gonna visit me in jail, Batman? My parents.
What? Parents?
A Superman? I do not give two shits about Crime Alley or Kansas anymore. I am so tired of Batman.
Hey, DC, whisper something to you real quick.
God.
Y'all got more than fucking two goddamn characters.
Jeez. Anything.
How many times am I going to see Bruce's parents get blown away in that fucking alley?
Yeah.
After a while, I really don't care anymore.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, I've seen that before.
Yeah. Yeah, no shit. Martha! You know what? Maybe instead of killing them, they just turn into a big old gangbang. You know what I mean?
And Bruce gets traumatized.
And Bruce just gets straight walks in on his dad just getting fucking pickled from behind.
And then it pans out and it's him up on a cathedral, and that's how he became Batman.
Just crying on the roof.
With lightning.
You'll never forget that. Ever.
Justice!
Parental nudity is never forgotten. I'm thankfully have avoided all potential parental sex, but I've caught some fucking nudity and I've never forgotten it.
You want to know how I became Batman?
You know how I got these scars?
I saw
Thomas motherfucking. And now, it's about justice.
Who's actually motherfucking Thomas?
Fuck.
So we're doing pretty good in Europe, eh?
This guy pumping it when Pompeii was by Mount Vesuvius.
Yeah. On that note of a man that was actually jerking off when Pompeii happened in 79 CE, whatever that stands for.
That's not.
I just saw the picture.
It's not even real.
We don't know that.
There's no way that dude was jerking off.
Wouldn't that be cool?
It'd be fucking awesome. I wish it was one of those leaning against the wall ones. You know what I mean?
One leg up on a chair. Just getting in it.
Call that the explainer. Let me tell you something.
You two look kind of familiar. Ain't you them kids that have been whacking off in my tool shed?
Randy don't like cockroaches. She's almost put us in the fucking oncoming traffic because there was one in the car one time.
Nah, I just stomped that bitch out and keep driving.
Well, could you maintain your cool if a cane spider sat on your hand while you were driving?
Fuck no, son. We're Thelma and Louise.
Oh, guaranteed, son.
We're holding hands and going over the cliff, son.
It flashes back to you when you got the head scarf on and the shaky.
Tinka lights near the shore. Rings out a warning cry. Oh, well, that is just my medicine. She says,
how'd you really feel about that fucking alien? You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna ask the real questions.
Well, what was up with that little glowy thing?
Yeah, you know, were you okay with that thing in your house? Sleeping in your fucking kid's room?
That was a big finger.
That was a big finger. You can get out of my kid's closet, all right? I'm gonna chain you up out back. I'll see you in the morning.
I mean, he's coming up to you with that finger out.
Is it?
Ow.
Easy.
Ow.
I'm just trying to get some water.
Ow.
How do you kill him with light, right?
No, that's gremlins.
Oh, okay.
Light. Tink, dear tink.
Out.
Who lives?
So much dangerous shit. I remember them like driving down the road and just spraying poison into the air to kill this mosquito.
It just spray in your face.
We were out there just playing baseball or
breathing
whatever.
Shit. Not just micro doses of it.
I guess it's time to go in. The pesticide trucks are chasing us.
You guys that didn't grow up in the South or even here in Hawaii have no clue what we're talking about.
They might.
But in the South,
maybe they have a variation.
They like to get the shittiest truck in the neighborhood and put this goddamn turbine in the back. With this fucking 50-gallon drum of fucking pesticide, and they just roll by while you're all out there just playing catch. Just
fucking cloud you up.
And just
no get care in the world.
Just lungs full of fucking DDT.
They cared more about killing them fucking mosquitoes than your well-being.
And it never killed the mosquitoes. If anything, it made them worse.
Yeah, definitely gave everybody cancer for sure. I'm just waiting for my number to be called, man. Honestly. I'm enjoying the time I got while I got it. You know?
I've got another puzzle for you.
I still think that every month that passes, there should be Oompa Loompas that show up and sing.
There should be.
Oompa Loompa Loopity-Doo. I've got another riddle for you. September is fucked. Loopity doo.
What would you do if I came on your ass?
Would you like a gobstopper?
Oompa loompa doompa dee doo.
you are wise, you'll listen to me.
Come on, dude. It's shell kicking time.
I was just talking to a customer the other day. I remember being a little kid and waiting in line to meet Michelangelo. And I was so fucking stoked to meet Michelangelo. I actually bathed. And I was standing in line. I think it was at like a JCPenney's or a Sears or somewhere in fucking Florida, right? And I'm sitting there and we keep getting closer and closer and closer. I'm like seeing little pieces of the grain. It's like, oh, that's him. There's Mikey over there. I'm so close. And when I finally got up to it, man, it was just the worst looking shit I've ever seen, you know?
You could totally tell it was fake.
It was just like some dude that just had this like flannel shit on, with wearing this hard backpack. And I remember they kind of forced me to hug him and I refused to touch him because I just felt defeated. I wish I had that photo still. That other asshole from the 80s, old Kirk Cameron. He's a dickhead Christian, too.
He did all his Left Behind movies,
yeah,
where everybody got sucked up in the fucking space.
Oh my god.
He got left behind.
Shut up.
Because you were a sinner.
Fucking Sky Santa Claus.
My name is Kirk Cameron, and I used to play on some great television in the 80s, but yes. I decided I was going to make Jesus movies. But I'm left behind.
Just like it. We're going to get that Cameron heat, son.
I play the part of a sinner, and I get left behind on Earth. I have to reclaim my soul. Watch it on ABC, family.
I will, Kirk. What time?
9 o'clock Eastern, 10 Pacific.
That's actually perfect. I'll be home.
Don't forget, Left Behind.
Thank you so much, Kirk. Very helpful.
Don't get sucked up.
If Church was just like that, I might go. Like, hey, don't get sucked up, huh?
You just remember what your old past said, for you've got a friend in me.
Dude, I read some really weird shit.
Did you? What you got?
On the shoulder.
Yeah.
So I've been reading the the book called Makeup and Breakup by legendary Kiss drummer Peter Criss.
Okay.
And there's a particular point in that book where when the original Fearsome Foursome was going hard and strong in the 70s,
yeah,
Ace Frehley was sitting there putting his makeup on one night. Peter Criss, who had a legendary big old donker,
okay,
put it on Ace Frehley's shoulder, and Ace Frehley just looked over at it and gave it a kiss.
Oh. Well, hey, that's all right. Whatever, man.
I've never had that kind of friendship before.
You know? And you never will with me.
No, I don't. I mean, you know.
But you're kind of like a spaceman, huh?
No, actually, I'm a plumber. On the side.
Hey, well, listen, I got a little piece of pipe backstage I'd like to have you work on.
Tell me about it.
Find my baby, gonna hold her tight.
Stop
gonna
it.
Grab some afternoon
fucking
delight.
Stop that shit. Jeez. That's how this fucking movie ends?
Yeah.
So everybody that's been coming in here telling me about fucking Phantasm and trying to put it on the same level as, like, the Friday the 13th series, even the Freddy fucking series.
Thinking of you is working
Halloween.
Up my appetite.
Y'all need to back the fuck up.
To a little afternoon delight.
Phantasm is not on that Michael Myers level, son. It is not on the Exorcist level. I don't want to hear it brought up with the Omen, Jaws, anything that was important. And you need to knock it the fuck off with that goddamn song, or I'm going to throw some shit at you. Stop it.
Our rockets in flight. Afternoon delight. Afternoon delight.
Together. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, gotta hope that was a fart.
But there's been some times where I was talking to customers and I thought I was gonna shit myself working those really horrible abdominal pains and you just want to start screaming in their fucking face for no reason. And they're like, what's wrong? And you're like, I gotta shit. You have to leave. Oh my God.
I don't care how much it is. Just throw $5.
I can't talk to you anymore.
What, it's a $300 statue? Just give me five. Just give me $5. I gotta shit.
With the Micronauts. Or any of this shit. I don't care. Look at us. We're losers. Who gives a shit about any of this?
Did you get one of them burritos too, man? What's to do? Eat a little bit of ice cream with it. Oh, come on, ice cream.
Dobby, sir. Dobby the house elf.
Okay, I need a dose of some fucking elves and shit. It's been a while.
Why are you on this elf train?
I just want some, man.
Get you a Dobby and give him a sock?
I just want to fucking, you know.
You know, you need like always a hobbit. Be Luke's friend.
Yes, that's exactly what I want.
Get you a Dobby to comic store elf.
Oh, with the fuck? With AIDS. An 8-foot long dick he just drags around the place.
And he keeps it in a sock.
Yeah, that's it. Oh my.
Nobody ever given Dobby a present before. Master Luke gave me.
I told you, you gotta stop giving elven customers AIDS.
But they were shitty, Master Luke.
I don't even know who the fuck this character is. I've never watched any of the movies.
I will always be your friend.
I don't want friends. Oh.